Happy New Year, everyone! I took a little bit of a break and I am back with videos every Friday. I hope everyone had a great holiday and New Year. I thought because it's a time of fresh beginnings and goal setting and reaffirming your priorities, I would talk about something that a lot of people think about but have a hard time doing. It's budgeting. I just wrote a blog post all about how my husband and I managed to figure out a budget and how we keep it every month. So if you'd like to read that one, it's in the description below. As I was writing that article, I realized that there are so many facets to dealing with money as a couple. First off, everyone comes to a marriage with prior experience and stories in our head about what money means. A lot of that has to do with how you grew up and how your family managed or mismanaged money. I also wrote a blog post about this because it's so important, and I'll put it in the description below. Basically, it's really important to analyze our feelings when it comes to money because it will come up in your discussions with your spouse. Money can mean a lot of things to people, from security to trust to just being a grown-up. And being aware of the root of these feelings can be oh so helpful. But today I want to emphasize a point that I touched on in the article that I want to emphasize because I feel like it's so important. So I'm going to make a whole video about it. Let's do this. Often, I'd say extremely often, you have one spouse who likes to spend less and save more. And you have another spouse who doesn't worry too much about that and has a bit more of an optimistic outlook on the bank balance. So when the couple chats about money, it can go something like this. Honey, I really want to buy that gym membership and it's only $100. I think we could squeeze that in. But I don't know. Do you think we can afford that? I don't know. It's just $100. I'm sure we can fit that in somewhere. I don't know, honey. You're always spending so much money. Does that sound familiar to you? The conversations around spending money, whether it's on the go, like deciding if you can eat out that night, or if it's about big purchases, it's always gonna be like this unless you do one extremely important thing. Now listen carefully. You need to plan a time together when you are not gonna be interrupted by the kids, when you've both eaten and are in relatively good moods, to sit down in front of the computer, open it up, sign on to your online banking, and have a look at the facts. Look at your last month's spending and see what you're actually spending on eating out, on coffee runs, on online purchases, on all this stuff that we don't keep track of. The facts are your friend when you are dealing with two different viewpoints about your bank balance and your spending habits, regardless of if you're pessimistic or optimistic. Obviously, when you're doing this, you're gonna have to reel in those urges to blame one another, because I know it's gonna happen. You need to see every time that you do this together as an opportunity for both people to start fresh. Because if one person is worried about being found out, they're not gonna wanna do this, they're gonna avoid it, and then the problem is gonna keep on going. I went searching around my books to see what the marriage experts have to say about this topic, and I found this awesome thing in this awesome book that I always talk about, The 7 Principles for Making Marriage Work by Dr. John Gottman. He was talking about a couple of clients that he had, and I want to read a part of it for you. He said, when Tina and Jean filled out the budgeting form, a simple solution did not present itself. But the process of looking through their expenditures together transformed the emotional climate between them dramatically. Rather than arguing about the issues, they felt like a team again. And that's what we want to feel like. We want to feel like a team when it comes to money. So once you guys look at the facts together, regardless of who actually held the most realistic financial picture in their head. You can move forward to try to figure out a budget that's going to work for both of you and plan how to keep it every month. I hope this little tidbit of information has helped you guys. I know that my husband and I are constantly relearning this over and over again. You'd think we would know to just open up the computer and look at it together, but no, we kind of get off in the theoretical often and then have to come back again. If you found this video helpful, I would be thrilled if you would share it with your friends, and then we can help more people and more marriages together. It's awesome. You can find little helpful buttons below to share it all on social media platforms. I hope you guys have a great day. Happy budgeting. Bye.